Lab-RAT-ory. We've been relaxing a little bit and hanging out and, you know, preparing some ideas and stuff. And the reason why I'm making this video is that last night we went to see Maxx, and I wanted to talk a little bit about it. This is not a formal review of the movie whatsoever, or the performance, or anything to do with the movie directly. But, you know, it's very important that those of you who haven't seen it go see it, because, and this is the reason why I'm making this video. You know, sometimes you finish a series of builds, or you finish a build and you feel a little drain. And, you know, we talk about this all the time in the laboratory. You need to get your creativity back, your mojo, whatever you call it. And this is as good a source or resource for that as any. I mean, the movie, you know, from my point of view, is fabulous. You don't need to know anything about Mad Max. You don't need to, whether you like that kind of movie or not. It doesn't have to, you know, resonate to anything that's going on in the real world. It's just a pure entertainment movie for us. And so we watch it like that without thinking too much into it. We don't even know the names of the actors or anything like that. I mean, we do, but that's not important. What's important is that it's a fantastic, mind-expansive movie for those of us who build models. And so my recommendation is go see it, you know, see it for yourself as soon as you can. And that might entail, of course, spending a lot more money than like I normally would spend on a movie. I normally wait for it to come out on Netflix, blah, blah, blah. But all of the kids in the family, you know, wrote or called to say, you know, as soon as you possibly can, go see this movie. And so we did, and we're glad we did it. And so we're getting on here to alert you that the movie has been out for I think a couple of weeks now, and it's doing very well. It's getting great word of mouth, in part because it's just one of those movies that, again, it doesn't connect to the sequel. I mean, it does, but you know, you don't have to follow it because of the sequel. It's a standalone movie for me, and the vehicles are out of this world. The eye candy is just amazing. And so it's going to give you, trust me, it's going to give you plenty to think about. And it's just going to make you look at your gallery of kits on your shelves, you know, and make you wonder, you know, what could possibly be next, what kind of a touch you can add to your own vehicle. So we've been doing this since the first Mad Max. But this is a wonderful, wonderful eye candy. And so I encourage all of you to go see it and judge it for yourself. Don't come with anything in mind other than you're a model builder and you're looking at it for just the eye candy and the ideas that it's going to give you. And so, you know, we walked out of there with lots and lots of ideas and lots of favorite moments. And so we're energized, and that's the idea behind going to see a movie like that. And so at that level, the money spent is well worth it. And maybe when the movie comes out on DVD or hits Netflix, if it ever does, or cable, we'll watch it a few more times. But the first time you watch it, you will remember most of the models that you've seen in that movie, and the you know, the car models, the make, all of that. And again, it's just going to make you salivate. You're going to leave the theater drooling. So anyway, we're doing well. We'll start making more videos here pretty soon. So we hope you're all doing well, and keep up with the good work. All right, my friends, Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory.